Hello and welcome to Hot Money Technicals on Bloomberg Quint Live, India's first digital live streaming business news service. This is a show which gets you a complete wrap of the key buzzing stocks in trade. In today's session, maybe key ideas for trade. I'm Dheeraj Shah, filling in for Darshan Mehta. Let's welcome all our experts then today. Dhyaneshwar Padwal of KIFS Securities, Raja Venkatraman of Chart Advice, and Brijesh Bhatia of Deal Money Securities join us on the show. Gentlemen, all three of you, thanks so much for joining. I really appreciate your time. I just have time to squeeze in one more quick question. Because the markets are looking so weak, expiry is around the corner, people would be wanting to know, quick 30, 40 seconds each. Brijesh, starting off with you first. The index, 10, 8, 20. What should one do, if anything at all? What are the levels?
I think one should look for long opportunity.
At the current levels.
With a stop loss of 10,756 on the spot, and probably 950, 960 could be levels one can look on the higher levels.
For the December series?
For the December series.
So you're playing for a long in the December series itself?
Itself.
Okay. Yeah. Raja, what about you?
Yeah, I would look to short with a stop loss about 10,910 for a target towards 10,600.
10,600. So you are bearish.
I'm bearish
on the Nifty.
And I'll be looking to buy on lower levels.
For the current series?
Yes, for the current.
But you do believe that right now you should initiate a short because there is a fall, a possibility of 150 point downside on the Nifty?
Yes.
Okay. Dhyaneshwar, what about
you? With the Brijesh, because if you look at the overall option data, so 10,800 put option having a highest open ratio, that could be in support for the, I would go long by keeping a stop loss of 10,760 for an initial leg of up move towards the 11,000 mark.
Okay. What about the Nifty Bank? Because that's a key determinant to this time around. This series has been a bigger lead indicator of sorts. Brijesh, again, starting off with you. On the Nifty Bank, what's the trade? If you're bullish on the Nifty, you certainly can't be bearish on the Nifty Bank.
No, I am still bullish on Bank Nifty as well, but I would probably look for buying around 26,950, 970 sort of zone, which is around another 800 points slightly lower side, and expecting back to around 27,250 to 300 levels on the upside for the December series.
Okay, so interesting. Both the Nifty and the Nifty Bank, but Brijesh believes the Nifty Bank, you can initiate a long at a slightly lower level. The Nifty, you can initiate a long at a higher, at the current level itself.
Yeah.
Now, Raja, if you're bearish on the Nifty, is your stance on the Nifty Bank the same?
No, Nifty Bank is neutral.
Because neutral.
Nifty Bank is playing out much better than Nifty. So, if something has to save Nifty, it'll be Nifty Bank.
But you would not, so you won't trade the Nifty Bank? Either on the long
the
side
bank.
Or on the short
no,
side?
No.
You just leave it alone?
Leave it alone.
Okay. The next stock is Mahindra & Mahindra, and let's invite Raja, who is betting on that stock. Raja, what is the indicator, what is the chart indicating?
Yeah, the chart of Mahindra has been witnessing some decline over the last few months. And what I have noticed is, if you take the entire move from September last year to now, it's actually come to a crucial support around the 700 region. And at 700 levels, it's trying to revive with bullish candlestick patterns, and that is indicating some upside which can be seen here. Plus, the momentum is also seen reviving, and all this in conjunction is adding to some bullish possibilities. And the stock right now has come into a pullback zone. You can also see there is a trend line breakout which has been witnessed in the last week, which saw almost the last 10 trading sessions, it has moved up by around 75 to 80 points. And that is why the bullish momentum is coming at lower level. So now the stock can be envisaged for some further upside.
How do you decide that this is where you're forming that line
correct.
Above which the stock is moving up?
So what I've done is I've used a concept of divergence. And this is called as a positive divergence using the RSI. And this is what is actually prompting the stock to go higher.
Okay.
It's on the weekly chart, so the impact is more powerful.
Okay. So does it need to go above a particular level to confirm the trend, or is the trend already in place?
It's already in action, so one could actually buy here and buy on pullback.
Okay, so the current price is about 783.
Correct.
You're comfortable buying at the current price?
Buy at current levels and buy also on pullback towards the 7.
So therefore, don't buy everything at one go?
Yeah.
Buy about what, 25-30% or more?
Buy 50% here and buy 50% on pullback towards 760 to 770.
Okay, and the targets that you envisage?
Target is around 895.
Around 895. And this is a positional target, I'm guessing.
Yeah, this is a positional target.
Okay, so positional call as per the RSI from Raja on Mahindra & Mahindra. The next one on our radar is Century Textiles. And Raja, if you can come in and tell us, why have you chosen Century Textiles?
Yeah, Century Textile has been on a decline in the earlier part of the year. After that, it formed a double bottom. And the double bottom breakout saw a good move to the upside. And once it reached its double bottom target, there was a decline and it was largely profit booking. And now what has happened is based on the this is a Ichimoku setup which I have used.
What is an Ichimoku?
Ichimoku is a Japanese way of analyzing
the
charts.
That I figured, but correct. What does it say?
It says that there are multiple lines. It's an extension of concept of moving average. And what it does is, if the price is trading above these two lines, it is a positive sign. And the price started trading above these two lines, and the stock did well. It did well right at the open today also. Mm-hmm. Right now, it's actually declining into some supports. Mm-hmm. Supports are in the region of 925. So one should actually be looking to buy at current levels, the stop loss below 905, for an upside towards 1000.
Okay, so I'm wondering, out there at this level as well, Raja, the stock did trade above the two lines, right?
Yes, but stock it has come off. Above.
But it has come off. Yeah, so why is this a buy signal? Because out here too it's gone up and correct. It's trading above. Yeah. And you're using the same concept there.
I'm using the same concept there.
The stock can fall then too.
Yeah, you're right on that count. Along with the price, I'm combining the momentum also.
Okay.
I'm using both.
Okay.
So along with the price, I'm combining this momentum.
Okay.
So which indicates that there is a much better positive direction.
Okay.
Compared to this section, if you can see here, and compared to this section, you can see the momentum indicator. The green line is a positive sign. Actually coming up
okay.
compared to that area.
Okay.
So the chances of this trade working out is much higher.
Okay, interesting. So as per the Ichimoku indicator, buy on Century Textiles.